Welcome to Hive Mind. This is Edge with my co-host Speaker. How's it going, Speaker?
Not too bad. How you doing?
I'm doing all right. Hey, doing you right. You just celebrated Straya Day. How was that?
Can you say it properly?
Straya Day.
It's like you're making fun of my country here. I don't like it. Straya.
Straya.
Straya with an S.
Okay, got it.
Yeah. I mean, we can get into that too, because this talk we're going to talk about, they want us divided, and they want us divided in many different fields and avenues. And one thing we saw in Australia at the moment with Australia Day, there is protests going on about that as well. But we can get into that a little bit later. Where would you like to lead from, Madge?
Interested to hear about that, actually. We're definitely going to talk about this. This is something that has been on both of our minds over the last few days. Yeah. And it's really something that's been weighing heavily on us and that we just felt like needed to be talked about. So, you know, over the last several days, since the inauguration, we've watched as a lot of patriots, they've been processing their confusion, their anger, their feelings of worry, anxiety, betrayal, all of that. And there's been some lashing out of emotions on social media, some of it aimed at fellow patriots who are also just trying to make sense of everything that's been happening and where we go from here. And what we're seeing is just a lot of a fracturing of this truth movement, this populist movement, whatever you want to call it. And people are drawing lines, you know, on where they stand on certain topics like QAnon or on the idea of the military coming and stepping in and doing something about this illegitimate president, et cetera, et cetera. And the net result looks to me a lot like wasted time and energy fighting amongst ourselves and causing division at a time when it's incredibly important that we focus on uniting and agreeing, and that we need to combat a common enemy and start rebuilding an alternative to their system that's designed to enslave us. So where do you stand on this, Speaker?
It's really hard to say at the moment. You and I over the last 7 days have not been in total alignment either, and I guess that's why we wanted to talk to this about this. I mean, we've sorted out our differences and how we feel about things, and even though they are not completely aligned, we still accept, and you know, we've moved on from it. But what we're seeing at the moment is, and this is like the thing that really irked me yesterday, it was Tracy put out a video, and I don't know if you follow Tracy, if you like her or not, it doesn't matter. She's definitely one of us. She's definitely a person that's been trying really hard to uncover the truth. And she's a really, really good journalist, and I put her up there with Corey on the same level. She put out a video the other day, she's actually deleted it now, where she unleashed, because she stated her point of view and she stated her opinion, and she got maliciously attacked for it. And I couldn't stand it, man, because it breaks me when you see, and some of them might be trolls, but I have seen a lot of people really picking groups and picking sides here about what they believe and what they don't believe. And I mean, she received death threats, and she didn't think they were credible, but still, that you don't want sort of that coming from your own side, right? And it really irked me, man. It really pissed me off.
Yeah, and we're just using Tracy here as an example, a recent example, but definitely seeing this as a theme lately over the last several days since the inauguration. There have been a lot of kind of lines drawn among different groups within the truth movement, within the populist movement, on where each of us stands. And it's understandable that we all don't necessarily agree on everything. And Speaker and I, as you mentioned, we don't necessarily agree on everything.
Especially not lately.
Yeah, actually, you're right.
I am right.
You're right. But we've kind of moved past that and realized that there's more important things to focus on. And so just using Tracy as an example there, but and yeah, I think you I agree that there's probably a mixture of, paid shills or bots or whatever who are purposely trying to sow division, but then also other people, real people, who are just really emotional, have a very specific point of view, and just are kind of lashing out because of the heightened emotions and feeling very passionate in one way, and thinking that maybe if you don't see things exactly that way, then questioning their motives, So I think that some people are just really taking a hardline approach to things. And if you don't believe exactly what they believe, then they're resorting to these personal attacks. And I think that if we do that, then we're actually just no better than the left.
No, we're exactly the same as the indoctrinated left, if that is the case.
Yeah. And
If you're trying to shut down people for their own beliefs and how they see things or how they go about things, you absolutely know better than them.
they're the ones that are wanting to silence opposing views. We're supposed to be the ones who welcome free speech and free thought. I've always believed that in a free market of ideas, it's the best ideas are always going to rise to the top, while the bad ideas are rejected. And it's only under this artificial climate that big tech and fake news media created that the bad ideas are boosted and the good ideas are suppressed. But in theory, in a free market of ideas, that should be the case where the good ideas rise to the top. And I say just let the people be free and say what they think, and time will just tell if those ideas resonate with the public or get rejected. What do
And
you think?
but you also have to be open to criticism, and you also have to be open to, the fact that you might be wrong, or that someone that you listen to or someone that you follow might also be wrong, and that's a big problem that I'm seeing. I've always said this about our work. I mean, you don't trust us, go do your own research. I'll always say it, right? You're free to do whatever you want. But what I'm getting now is I'm seeing a lot of people attached to certain, what you call them, truthers, freedom speakers, or whatever they are. And they're taking hardline stances when another truther says something else or disagrees with them or something like that. And it's sort of like people are creating cliques here, and it's not good because it is exactly what the left want with. Which is dividing people who only want justice. I mean, that's the main goal here, right? Justice, freedom.
Yeah, exactly. And while we're busy squabbling about what may or may not happen next and how or when things are exactly going to play out, the enemy is unified against us. We've got the communists, the socialists, the globalists, the technocrats, the deep state corrupt establishment. They're all expending every resource they have to silence us, oppress us, and make us disappear. So, in essence, we're doing them a favor when we waste time fighting amongst each other. Ourselves and self-policing our own patriots on what they should or shouldn't say, when we really just need to regroup, unify, and focus on the enemy. And the enemy's real, it's a threat to humanity, and we're wasting time arguing amongst each other, I think.
Yeah, we really are, and I hate it. I hate seeing it. But it's getting to a point where it's just there's some platforms that I don't want to be a part of at the moment, and I don't want to like see or something because it just it, sometimes it reminds me of Twitter, and I don't want to be there. So.
Yeah, I get what you're saying, and I think that we do need to really just regroup and focus on the commonalities. I mean, for example, Speaker and I, and we just brought this up. Speaker and I don't see eye to eye on everything, especially lately. But we've found that there are several things, and we've found there are several things that we disagree on. But we're just more interested in focusing on our commonalities. Just because you don't agree with everything I think, that doesn't mean I think you're a shill or not a patriot, and vice versa.
How did you know?
yeah,
You
and Speaker
uncovered me.
and Speaker and I came to this understanding a long time ago, and we just decided, that we have a common enemy, a common goal to fight against the tyranny, a common drive to work hard and do everything within our power to achieve those goals, even though we have very different ways of going about it. And what we've built with Hivemind is just an example of how we as a community can use these differences that we have as a strength rather than considering them a weakness. What do you say?
100%. I mean, like anyone that's followed us or follow us on two different platforms can clearly see the difference between us both. It's massive. It's very big. But when it comes to our common things, it's not, because we all want the best. I mean, these people have they want us divided in every way, shape, or form, whether it be left versus right, which we've seen for 4 years, galvanizing the side. I mean, there is no, the polarization that they have created between ideologies and people, races, genders, is it's almost to a stage in a larger degree where it is ununiting. I don't think that maybe it's possible. But it is possible within our own idealistic views, despite different things. So, like Edge was saying before, I'm on Minds, she's on Gab, two very different platforms, two very different people. But the commonality is the same. Like, they want the same. They want to live their lives. They're logical. They're rational, they can see what's going on, and they haven't been sold this indoctrination. Even though they might not agree with your religious views, even though some of their views on certain things might be completely different than yours, we all want the same thing. We really do. And like, that has to be the thing that brings us together, and especially not the maliciousness I've seen within our own ranks.
The left wants to promote and glorify this diversity of every kind, whether it's, skin color, sexuality, whatever the case. The only kind of diversity they will not accept is diversity of thought. And that's what makes us different. That's exactly what we value, is diversity of thought and the freedom of everyone to express their ideas, whether they're popular or not. And we've got to get away from this toxic groupthink and start thinking for ourselves and allowing others to do the same without fear of being threatened. And like I said, the good ideas are going to rise to the top, the bad ones are going to get rejected.
And
Just.
you see what they've created with that. Sorry to cut you off.
No, that's all right.
What they've done with this, and I've noticed this, especially with the pushing of races against it, the pushing of races and sexes against each other has been one of their largest, most successful weapons. If you can push black against white, if you can push male against female, it has been one of their greatest victories in indoctrination. And we're seeing this throughout Europe now, that through the radicalization of the other side's belief, let's take BLM for example, which there is certain aspects of BLM that is incredibly racist towards white people. Now, racism is racism. It doesn't matter what color you are. Of course, they haven't been taught that, or they don't believe that, but that is the truth, right? And the truth is what holds strong. So now you've created radical right movements like you're seeing on here, in Europe and all that as well, because of the radicalization of the left. All planned, all systematic, and you see rising up of these groups. I mean, we're seeing this all over the world at the moment, right? From the Netherlands, to Asia, France, to USA. It's crazy. It's crazy, and it's all by design. There is nothing coincidental about this. Australia is another one. I mean, Australia Day is a big catalyst for that, which I'll go into because of it. So a lot of natives and white liberals, of course, believe that Australia Day is Invasion Day. where the colonization of Australia began, and it is racist and it is a terrible holiday and no one should celebrate it and they should change the date and the name. And that's what's driving us apart down here, because plenty of Australians don't think that, right? They understand that history is history. It's just not where we are now, right? So instead of unifying under something like nationalism, you have to destroy nationalism in every facet of it globally.
Right. That's what it seems like is happening there. And we've seen elements of that here in the US as well. Feelings and sentiments in the same direction. And I do think that it's designed to get people away from a sense of nationalism, have this again promote this idea. It goes along with the critical race theory and this belief that the country's systemically racist because of our racist origins, and that we should reject basically our history because of its history, the history of racism in this country. And the foundation of the country itself was, founded on racism. And so basically rejecting throwing everything, about the history of our country and the founding of our country out the window because of slaves and slave ownership at the time that the country was founded. And so it really is, I think, just designed to again try to break down this feeling of nationalism, of national pride, because they want globalism. I mean, the people who are behind this type of rhetoric and this type of ideology want globalism. And so they don't want you to have a sense of national pride. They want to shame you and guilt you into thinking that, just because you grew up in this country and the country has a history of slave ownership, then that somehow means that the entire system is racist. And so
And they've pushed this indoctrination so hard on these people, and we see it in the mainstream. We see it from big time gamers to Hollywood celebrities pushing the idea of white privilege, which is such a fallacy that's so easy to debunk that it's not even funny. I mean, do you think the person of like a family, a white family from the deep south, has more privilege than the Obamas? It's easy to eradicate. Do you know what I mean? Like, look at Eddie Murphy's kids. Do you think a poor family, a poor white family's got more privilege than them? Of course, they don't. Right? The only privilege that I see in society at the moment is elite privilege.
right. And if you happen to be on the left, it seems that you have the privilege to speak without censorship, to be glorified because of your thoughts being in line with the establishment. And it's really if your thoughts are divergent from the establishment, that seems to put you at a disadvantage more than anything, more than, race or ethnicity or sexuality, anything. It's really more of diversity of thought that's under attack.
And the truth is under attack massively. The truth in any way, shape, or form. I mean, what we're seeing now in big tech is the start and the foundation of George Orwell's The Ministry of Truth. That is what they're trying to be. That is what they're working towards.
Right. And we just need to recognize that it's a divide and conquer tactic that's being used. against us, and that we need to not play into that by attacking people who we know are on our side, who have a common goal, who may not share exactly the same ideas, or perspectives, but obviously are working towards the same common goal of fighting a common enemy, which is the establishment, that seeks to oppress us. And so I think that we're playing right into their hands when we're wasting time doing that, don't you?
Yeah, 100%. Like I said, there's huge divides on our side too that we have to mend, especially between like Christians, non-Christians, a follower of a certain magic letter, and people that don't follow that dichotomy. You know, these things have to be worked out, and you have to be met in the middle. And rational thought is very important too.
Right. And the other thing I want to talk about on this topic of how they want us divided is this idea of the Patriot Party. And I know there were mixed reports on President Trump proposing a new party, the Patriot Party. And my initial thoughts on that were, it's not a bad idea. Maybe it's something that we should consider. But there's definitely opposing views to that, which are saying that, it's just going to divide us further. It's going to dilute our votes. It's going to ensure that they're going to keep power, et cetera, et cetera. And we really just need to stick with, the GOP and clean out the GOP.
Well,
But there was.
that's how I feel. I mean, I just don't think adding another party will do anything to benefit the overall federal vote.
Yeah, and I understand that perspective. And we have this new poll here. So this poll is suggesting that the idea of a Patriot Party actually has more support than the GOP right now, for good reason, because the GOP has betrayed us. But whatever the people do decide going forward, we need to be very thoughtful and careful about it. And here's why I say that. Just this week, Donald J. Trump for President, Inc. Filed a report. I think that we might have that, yeah. And this report has disavowed the activities of a committee named the Patriot Party, saying that the DJT for President, Inc. has nothing to do with the Patriot Party. So I'm actually interested to see which way this goes. Hopefully we can all unify. Whatever way it goes, we can all unify under one party, whether it's the GOP, the Patriot Party, whatever. And I'm hoping that the newly formed Office of the President, Office of the former President, Donald John Trump,
Now, if anyone didn't pick up on that trial, Biden started his own cabinet. What was it called? The Committee of President-elect or something. A totally made-up organization. So Trump just did
Yeah, so Trump
the
just announced the office of the former president, Donald
same.
Trump. And I'm hoping that we get some clarity from there on which way he's thinking about going and which way he's thinking about supporting, so we can kind of all rally behind one direction and go from there. What do you think?
I think that's the only way that we make any steps forward here.
Yeah. So a lot of division right now, and just really want to focus on moving forward and finding commonalities rather than differences, kind of like you and I have, speaker, lately. So, and just moving forward and
Like the way I look at things at the moment. And I'll lay it out here on how I see things. I have a tendency to live by the day and what's happening at this point in time, what I can see and what I can verify at that this moment. And I make my moves off that. Obviously something's happening. I mean, Corey seemed very excited when she messaged us the other night. So our podcast, I'm sure will be pretty exciting tomorrow. Once we record it with the three of us, But there does seem to be things going on, but I can only work with what I see now. That's just how I tackle the situation and it's how I can go day by day. Whether it's a painful reality or what, that doesn't mean I've given up and that doesn't mean I don't have hope. It just means I'm working on how I see things from a minute to minute basis.
Yeah, and I think that's actually a good way to go for now because still things are so much in the air. And it does seem like there's a lot of things happening behind the scenes that we're not privy to. But speculation on that, and especially on a public platform where you have an audience, I feel like people who have a large audience, who make predictions and set expectations. That's where, people really get invested. And when it doesn't go that way, they get real upset.
Yeah, it causes, either deep emotional scarring or some sort of dissociation, cognitive dissonance. All these things you've got to watch out for. And that's why I don't like to give people predictions. And that's why I really try to stay away from that. Because I don't like to sell false hope in any way, shape, or form.
Well,
I just like
especially
to
now,
report.
it's such a volatile time right now. Predictions a year ago or something different scenario. But right now, it just seems like it is important to kind of take things day by day, look for signs, look for news, look for things happening, but just really trying our best to stay within the reality that we're facing within each day, and having hope for something better, something better coming down the pipe, but without making promises or predictions on what that is going to look like this office of the former president Donald Trump. There's a sign, a fact, a piece of information that we can observe, and say, okay, so it looks like some things are happening, and that's a good thing, but not really speculating yet on exactly how things are going to play out. And not getting, say, angry or divisive or lashing out at people who see it that way, or who say, look, I'm prepared to face the harsh reality of what we're facing, and I'm not holding out hopes for this or that. Some people are in that place. It doesn't mean they're, not patriots or that they're shills. Just simply means that they're choosing to look at things, for the harsh reality that we're facing. And that's just their perspective. So, we all just have a different perspective. And if we can use that maybe as a strength rather than fighting amongst each other, on who's right, because we really don't know yet. We really don't know. Time's gonna tell. Time's gonna tell, really. We just need to chill out and see how things play out, in my opinion. What do you think?
100% noted.
Yeah, I feel like I was just rambling there,
That's okay.
but
Nothing wrong with a good ramble.
this is a ramble session.
Yeah, this is a rant that we had to get off our chests, so.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right.
So, well, it was a good ramble session. I'm glad that you enjoyed your Australia day, not
Yeah,
Straya day.
Australia.
I
Get it
mean,
right, Jesus.
one of those things we don't agree on, I guess.
Yeah, just one of many. But it's all right. I can still tolerate you. You're all right.
Yeah.
You're
You're all right.
right.
All right,
All
guys.
right.
Well, thanks for joining us here today on Hive Mind. Please be sure to share this podcast. Check out the links in the description. You can find all of our alt tech platforms on our website to find more of the work that we do and the places that you can find us. So We'll see you back next time, right here on Hive Mind.